Mercedes-Benz believes in being the best or nothing. The brand has only become younger with time. Sportier designs, faster cars. But has Mercedes somewhere lost its promise of being the best? Let's find out. I chose to drive the CLA shooting brake across Switzerland. Let's talk about the car's safety features first. Mercedes has always made the world's safest cars, and CLA is no exception. The car comes loaded with safety features like airbags, ESP, ABS, EBD, hill hold and descent control, brake assist, etc., along with some nicer features like collision prevention and attention assist. The steering is super light and very drivable even in low speeds. It weighs up as you push the car. Direct steering response offers better control. I feel the brakes could be improved. With regards to safety, the car scores quite high. Let's move on to specs. I drove the petrol CLA. With 155 horsepower and sufficient torque, the car is obviously not the fastest, but it is a comfortable highway cruiser. I drove this car at 180 km per hour, and the high-speed mannerism is good, like you expect out of a German brand. The car comes with Drive Select menu, so you could choose to move into sports or dynamic, and the paddle shifters are very handy too. So if you are in need of quick power in comfort mode, you could downshift a couple of gears and the car pulls through. The 7-speed dual-clutch transmission is quick and smooth, like you expect. The suspension on this car is good too. It is a well-put-together, beautiful piece of engineering. On the technology front, the infotainment isn't intuitive enough and doesn't get any touchscreen like the newer version of Mercedes. The car has the inconvenient command controller. Hey, by the way, did you know that brands such as Mercedes, BMW and Audi are moving towards touchscreen infotainments? What on earth made them think that touchscreens are inconvenient in the first place? The only gripe I had with this car was the seat comfort. Now you would believe that Mercedes are known to have the best seats in class, but I had great difficulty in finding the perfect driving position. That's not the case with C-Class and above. With regards to features, the car is pretty loaded. Despite the high amounts of insulation and sound deadening in the car is not super silent. You can hear the engine the moment you start revving. An enthusiast won't complain. With a large enough boot to fit two XL-sized suitcases, it is a good luggage carrier. And back seats are comfortable only for two average riders. In terms of styling, the car is aerodynamically perfect. It looks smart and is quite modern. Well, design and profile of CLA is the highlight. The main design elements of the car are the AC vents design that draws inspiration from the aviation industry, as well as the frameless windows. Whether in coupe or in shooting brake, the car definitely looks good and is a head turner. The car is based on the smaller Mercedes hatches, so it is more of an A class than it is a C class. Some hard plastics used in the car appear slightly cheap, and the cost cutting is quite apparent. This car is not the best representation of Mercedes, but the 2020 version of CLA fixes most of these problems and takes this car in the league of C class. So who is it made for? Well, if you are someone looking at tasting the German luxury and not into the GT line performance, CLA could be your pick. But hey, are you in your mid-30s and want to dress up like you are 24? Because CLA is just that, trying to be young and sporty.